Okay, so I saw this movie twice in theaters, and it's one of those films where it takes a while to understand what the hell you just witnessed. And immediately once you do and go upon rewatching it, you catch so much stuff that you swore you caught on the first time, but it makes much more sense. And you just feel accomplished, or at least that's how I felt. This is a film by Yorgos Lanthimos, who has never disappointed me with all his one movie I saw. And I gotta tell you, I am very surprised that this movie wasn't as disturbing as his others. Looking at the trailers, I expected it to be a well-told story with great acting, obviously, well shot. I've heard a bit of complaints about the fisheye lens being distracting and not for me at all. In fact, it enhanced my viewing experience as it felt panoramic. It seemed like you were seeing more than you thought was capable of watching in a movie. It felt panoramic and it was awesome. The way the camera, the tracking shots were perfect. This guy is the master of still shots. He follows the horses or the people walking, or the camera like stops moving all of a sudden to immediately start inching forward. It is just filmed so well. I don't know how Yorgos did all of this. There's a scene where the camera's backing up and you don't even see like a track being set down. You can tell that the camera was attached to wheels and he's walking it, but it looks as if it's on a track going forward and yet you don't see a track. I mean, oh, and I'm only talking about the filming of the movie. I haven't even gotten to the music. I haven't even gotten to the costume design. I haven't even gotten to the acting. Now, going into the two main stuff that I was talking about, the acting, the costume design, and the freaking music. Now, I can't find this score online, which kills me right now, because thinking of all these songs composed for this movie, and I just want to f***ing listen to it. The music is so strange. It's so beautiful. It's so cool. It's honestly the best score of the year. I just want to listen to it over and over again. But yeah, I mean, Fox Searchlight, what the f***? Just release it. Everyone wants to hear it. Everyone who's seen this movie wants to hear it. It adds tension to the scenes. It adds happiness to the scenes. It makes it feel like you're truly in this time period. And it was just perfect. The acting, oh my god. Emma Stone does the performance of her lifetime. Like, yeah, she blew me away when I saw The Help. She blew me even more away, like freaking out of the ballpark with La La Land. But in this movie, oh, she is so good. Rachel Weisz, she everyone was so good in this movie. The guy from Mad Max, what the hell's his name? Nicholas Hoult. He don't even get me started with Olivia Colman. Woo-hoo! This girl is such a good queen. She's such a good queen. She is charismatic and likable, but at the same time disgusting and is a giant bitch.
Look at me! Look at me! How dare you! Close your eyes!
I can't tell whether to love or hate her in this movie. I've seen this movie twice by now, and I haven't stopped thinking about it since then. And I can't tell if I love or hate her. She gives the best performance of the year, in my opinion. She was so good at playing this role that I'm almost convinced that she could be a real queen in real life. It was so good. She was so funny. She was so annoying. She was so likable, but she was a that you hated while watching it. I don't know how to feel about her character. I just love it. I love that I hate it and I hate that I love it. It's perfect. It's awesome. It's such an epic movie, and the costume designs, I mean, come on. Come on. The dresses, the suits, the wigs, the makeup. Yorgos Lanthimos, you've created your masterpiece, and I thank you for sharing it in Phoenix. And I got the chance to watch this movie twice. The second time I got to share it with friends of mine who truly loved it. I mean, holy shit, this movie was so good. I just want everyone to watch it. Please check it out. If you're skeptical on the ending, don't worry, I was the first time. Give it some thought, and if you can't, look up an online analysis, and if you think you know it, still check out an analysis. This movie can be interpreted different ways, but once I finally got it, I'm speechless. This movie was so f***ing good. It's the 20th century Barry Lyndon. This is as good as it gets, ladies and gentlemen. This movie was awesome. Please watch it. This is I'm I'm almost certain that this is going to be my favorite movie of the year. But please go check it out. It is so good. It is so good. It's so good. It's my favorite. It's my favorite. The favorite is my favorite of 2018. I should probably stop. 10 out of 10. Damn. I want to watch it again and again and again and again. It was such a good fucking movie. Woo!
I'm not quite following.
Shh. I apologize, but douche when I'm thinking.
The favorite.
Rated R. In select theaters November 23rd.